So today in this session we will study the Arrhenius concept of acid and bases. So what is actually definition given by the Arrhenius? So Arrhenius, he said that acid is a substance that furnishes H plus ion in aqueous solution. So these are the substance like HCl is substance. So if it is furnishing H plus ion aqueous solution, then this is called as an acid. So it can give in water. So H plus N, it will give you H plus N Cl minus in actually in water. So here you put a solvent water. So this is an acid. Similarly, acetic acid is an acid in water. So if you put the solvent water, so this will convert into this in water. So we can add aqueous and this can be an aqueous. So this is a weak acid. So since this is a weak acid, this product can go backward direction also. And this is a strong acid, this will go in forward direction. Similarly, what is a base? So a base is a substance that furnishes OH minus in aqueous solution. It is same thing. So this is a base, so it can give an OH minus in aqueous solution. So this is again a base in water. Similarly, ammonium hydroxide, so this is also in water, it will give you ammonium in aqueous solution and OH in aqueous solution. But this is a weak base because this reaction can go backward. So it is not going completely forward. So here dynamic equilibrium is established between this ammonium hydroxide in this ion. So this is called ion equilibrium. Now every hydrogen compound cannot be regarded as an acid. So like what does this mean? So let us take this example, methane. So methane contains one hydrogen, but this is not an acid. So if you put this methane in water, it will not give hydrogen. So every hydrogen compound cannot regard it in acid. So one is methane, similarly ethanol, similarly methanol, they have H plus, but they will never give OH. So they are also not called as bases. Now one more thing, that we are saying acid is releasing H plus ion. Actually H plus ion is do not freely exist in water. H plus ion is not freely exist in water. So why? Because they combine with the solvent molecules. They have a strong tendency to get hydrated. So it will never be right like H plus ion. So what is this H plus with water? It is hydrated, like it will form a H3O positive. So this is called as a hydronium ion. Like HX plus H2O, so it will give you H3O plus and X minus. So this H3O plus is the hydronium ion. So this hydronium ion is actually this is an American system we are calling hydronium ion. So UPAC has given the name is called as oxonium ion. So according to the UPAC, this is called as oxonium, and if you take the American system, it's called as hydronium. So this is basically just a nomenclature. In aqueous solutions, the hydronium ion is further hydrated to give ionic species. Like, so what they are giving, so if you take hydronium ion in water, it can again hydrate. So H3O plus, it will hydrate with water, it become H5O2 plus, again with water it become H7O3. This water is added, so on addition become this species. So this ionic species, again if you add water, it can be hydrated up to 9. So like it can be hydrated. Similarly OH also can be hydrated like this one. So on hydration, OH plus H2O, it will be H3O2 minus, again this plus H2O, this will give H5O3 minus, again this plus H2O, so this will give H minus O4 minus. So these are the ionic species. And so how many waters can be dissolved? So we can write the formula. So minimum is 2, 3, 4, this is the formula, H into H2O, N and plus. So what is N value? It can be 2, 3, 4, like this we can increase, like this we can increase. So H2O is associated through hydrogen bonding to give higher hydrates. So these are, we are getting these type of hydrates. So these hydrates are obtained by hydrogen bonding. What is the application of Arrhenius concept? So what is the application? So number one, it explains the acidic nature of aqueous solution in non-metallic oxides. So non-metallic oxides, it explains the acidic nature. So these are the non-metallic oxides, CO2, SO2, SO3, N2O3, N2O5, P2O3. So if you just pour this CO2 gas in, pass CO2 gas in water, this water becomes your acidic in H2CO3. So they will again giving H+. So this CO2 is also explaining, so this is a acid. It can also explain this is an acidic oxide. So by using water, we can explain this is acidic in nature. Similarly, SO3 is also acidic. Why? If you pass this gas in water, so it becomes H2SO4, and again in H2SO4, they are giving H plus ion. So protons are donated by the CO2 and SO3 when substituting in water. So these are the Arrhenius acids. It also explains the basic nature of aqueous solutions in several substances like metal hydroxide, like calcium oxide, sodium. How? So you just pass this calcium oxide in water, so you will become calcium hydroxide. You will get, and this calcium hydroxide again dissociated into calcium 2 plus and 2 OH minus. Like similarly, ammonia in water, you will get ammonium hydroxide NH 4 plus and OH minus. So these are dissociation. Here we cannot decide, but in water we can decide. Like this hydrogen in water, they are giving NH2 dot NH3OH, so it will give you NH3 dot NH3 plus. This is the cation and this is the OH. So they are explaining the, these are the bases. Water is amphoteric in nature, so water has both properties, that it can dissociate into H plus and OH minus. Okay, so water can give H plus and OH. So water is a acid also, water is a base also. This is called as amphoteric. Amphoteric means the substances which can give a proton as well as OH minus. Fourth, basically this is, it is a reaction. It is a reaction between H plus and OH minus to form water. So if you see this water, so this is acid, this is base. So it is also an application. It will give you H plus and OH to give water. So it is one application of acid and base reactions. From Arrhenius concept, we can also measure the strength of the acid and base. So it depends upon the tendency of acid base to furnish H plus and OH in solution. So we can also determine the strongness of the acid and base. So by using the law of ion equilibrium, so for acid, HA, suppose it's weak acid, H plus and O minus, so for Ka, we can get the value of K over H plus and OH minus by HA. So this for acid, so if the value of K is higher, so we'll get the stronger acid. If the value of K is lower, we'll get the weaker acid. Similarly for the base, so we'll use this one. Suppose this is a one base, it is giving B plus and OH minus. So by using the law of ion equilibrium, so B plus and OH minus and BOH. So we'll, this is the dissociation constant of base. So if the dissociation constant of base is higher, concentration of OH will be higher. Concentration of OH will be higher. More KB, more OH concentration, the base will be more stronger. Less KB means OH will be lesser, the base will be less stronger. So these are the some applications. Now we'll see what are the limitations in Arrhenius theory. So what is the limitation? What problems comes in Arrhenius theory? Actually, it fails to explain the behavior of acid and bases in non-aqueous solvents. Like dry HCl also act as an acid in absent solvent. Means without solvent, it is also acting acid, and it is also acting as acid when dissolved in water. So this, why this is acting as an acid in absence of solvent, from this Arrhenius theory is cannot explain. Arrhenius theory only explains if the substance is dissolved in water. So this is one of the big limitations. So it also fails to explain the neutralization reactions giving rise to salt formation in absence of solvent. Like CO2 plus calcium, it will form a salt. So without solvent, it can also form salt. They can also react. So again, it also fails to explain. It also fails to explain the acidic nature of certain salts like ACl3, BF3. So these are the acidic. But why they are acidic? So Arrhenius is totally fails to explain. Similarly, basic character of ammonia, phosphine, etc. in the absence of aqueous medium. So both are the reasons, both are the examples in which we cannot explain this is a acid or base. It fails to explain the fact that H plus ion exists in water as H3O. So why water existing as H3O? So from Arrhenius theory we cannot explain. Hydronium, that is the hydronium ion. So H plus is simplest and smallest ion, and they have a strong tendency to get hydrated. So it is get hydrated, but from Arrhenius theory we cannot explain it. So this is something different. And why they are hydrated? Because the hydration energy of H plus is very, very high, that is minus 256 kilocalorie per mole, due to which it is hydrated. So now we will understand the terms like acidity and basicity. Already we explained these terms in the previous chapter also, so let me repeat this thing. So what is the meaning of basicity? Basicity means number of H plus ion furnished by one molecule of acid. So if any acid is furnishing H plus ion, that is called basicity or protocity in acid. So we have like some acid which is monobasic, dibasic, tribasic, like monobasic, HCl, HNO3, CH3, COH. So if they are furnishing, they all can furnish only one H+. But if you see dibasic, they can furnish two. So one also furnish, two also furnish. If one is furnishing, it is called as monobasic. If there are two H+ furnishing, then they are called as dibasic. Similarly here, one they can also furnish H+, one and two. Here they also can furnish one and two. In tribasics, So like H3PO4, so we can see the structure. This is the structure of H3PO4. So here we can see why basic, because there are three OH is present, OH, but they cannot give OH, they will give only H plus ion. That's why it is called a tribasic acid. So here they can furnish 3 H plus ion maximum, 1, 2, or 3. So it can be depending on the type of H plus. So we can say monobasic, dibasic, and tribasic, maximum tribasic. Similarly, we have one more examples like here, H3O, H3PO3. So this can give you 2 H plus ion, H3PO3, 2 negative. Why? It is called a dibasic. If you see the structure here, we have 2 OH, means they can give maximum 2 H plus. 1 H also given and 2 also. So it is a type of 2 acid can be given maximum. If you see the H3PO3, so it is not H3PO3, it will be H3PO2. So 2 oxygen, you can see 2 oxygen, 1 phosphorus, 3 hydrogen. So these hydrogen attached to the phosphorus, so they are not liberated because this is a strong bond is formed. But here it is a weak bond. Because oxygen more electronegative, so this hydrogen can be furnished. So this is a monobasic acid. Basic why? Because this OH is there. And one hydrogen is given by this compound, so this is a monobasic. So depending on the type of structure, we can see which is a monoacidic or which is the base. Similarly, we have acidity. Acidity means hydroxidity of base. So what is the meaning of acidity? Number of OH ions produced by a base in its aqueous solution. So it can be monoacidic, diacidic, or triacidic base. Monoacidic, similarly, like monobasic acids. So if they have furnishing one OH like sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide, diacetic base, they are furnishing maximum 2. So maximum 2 means 2 OH like calcium hydroxide, barium hydroxide, like furnishing. If they are furnishing 1, it will be monoacidic. In diacidic base, if they are furnishing only 1 OH, then it will be monoacidic base. It can't be diacidic. If they are furnishing 2 OH, then it can be called as a diacidic base. Similarly, like a compound triacidic base. So in triacidic base, so what will you do? If they are furnishing maximum 3 OH ion, then it is called a triacidic base. If they are furnishing 2 here also, in triacidic base, if they are furnishing 2 or 1, then it is called as diacidic base. If they are furnishing 1 OH ion, then it is called as a monoacidic base. So it depends on the type of reaction. So here are some examples. AlOH is 3. So if they have maximum OH is 3, so they can give maximum OH 3. Here gallium hydroxide, they can give maximum OH 3. So these are the examples.